Consumer choices are increasingly shaped by algorithms that curate choice sets, rank those choices, and make recommendations. While technical details vary, these algorithms generally share a similar structure. User preferences are inferred from data on people's past choices and behavior. The implicit assumption is that what people choose is what they want, yet we know from behavioral economics that this is not always true. For example, a foundational insight from behavioral science is that people sometimes act automatically. When thinking fast, cognitive biases can creep in that do not appear when thinking slow, so quick decisions may deviate from the preferences we display when acting more deliberately. This raises the concern that algorithms trained on past behavior run the risk of automating our automatic tendencies rather than reflecting our more carefully considered preferences. This paper explores the implications for one particular kind of automatic bias, discrimination. Many of the forces that create discrimination operate quickly and can exert stronger influence over automatic choices. So biased behavior can be seen as a combination of two distinct elements: the prejudice that arises even when people make slow, deliberate choices, and the additional prejudice that can arise when they act automatically. This second element is an artifact of the choice process, and to the extent algorithms draw on this kind of automatic behavior, they may codify biases that users themselves do not consciously want. Concretely, these insights imply that algorithms will inherit more bias when they are trained on more automatic behavior. This paper tests that idea empirically for a specific kind of prejudice: our tendency to favor people like us and disfavor people not like us. The first set of tests consists of laboratory experiments in the US. Subjects were presented with a series of movie recommendations, each of which showed the name of the recommender. Users could click a button under each movie poster to read its full review, and they were asked to choose 4 movies from the 42 available. Crucially, 2 elements of the study were randomized. First, while the reviews themselves were real, the authors randomly assigned recommender names to saliently signal race and gender. Second, subjects were randomly assigned to make their decisions under a rushed or non-rushed condition. Those in the rushed condition had 5 minutes to make their selections, were told this was not much time given the task at hand, and were shown a timer that counted down in milliseconds. Those in the non-rushed condition had 15 minutes, were told this was plenty of time, and had a timer that counted down in seconds. The results show that subjects in the non-rushed condition do on average favor movies recommended by own group members, but this bias is more pronounced amongst those in the rushed condition. This is consistent with the idea that when making quick decisions, people's automatic actions may deviate from the preferences they display when acting more deliberately. But the key is that after the experiment, the authors used these data to build their own recommender algorithms. One was trained on the rushed condition data, the other on the non-rushed condition data, and both were then used to generate movie recommendations for the same fixed set of users. This figure shows that both algorithms, on average, rank own group recommended content more highly than out-group recommended content, but the bias is much larger here. Put another way, the algorithm trained on more automatic behavior inherits a higher degree of bias. Do these patterns extend to real-world settings? The paper explores this with audits of 2 Facebook algorithms: the newsfeed algorithm, which ranks posts from a user's friends, and the people you may know algorithm, which ranks potential new friends. Facebook users report lower levels of deliberation when interacting with newsfeed posts than when deciding whether to friend another user, which suggests that the newsfeed algorithm is trained on behavior that is more automatic. And in fact, using data collected from US users, the authors find significant outgroup bias in newsfeed rankings, but not in people you may know rankings. This figure plots the relationship between users' self-reported preferences for posts shown in their newsfeed and the algorithmic rankings generated by Facebook. Own and outgroups are defined by race, and we see that even conditional on user preferences, the algorithm downranks posts by outgroup members. So, for a white user, for example, the algorithm downranks posts by their black friends. In fact, own group posts in the bottom quartile of user preferences are on average ranked nearly as high by the algorithm as outgroup posts that are in the second quartile of user preferences. In contrast, there is no sign of outgroup bias for the people you may know algorithm, which is plausibly built on less automatic behavioral data. Moreover, these patterns are not specific to racial cleavages in the US. The authors replicate their findings in India, which is Facebook's largest market, and where the most salient divides are religious rather than racial. Here as well, there's significant outgroup bias in newsfeed rankings, but not in people you may know rankings. Thus, this paper argues that when trained on user choices that are relatively automatic, curation algorithms can learn and propagate biases that users themselves do not necessarily want. At a minimum, this suggests platforms should pay attention to the automaticity of behavior used in their training data. More broadly, these findings illustrate how insights from behavioral science can help build better human-facing algorithms. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related work. This includes research on algorithmic bias, thinking fast versus thinking slow, and behavioral biases more generally.